Demonstration of the changes and new functionality now available in the SETS system is best done from inside the SETS portal. Enter your username and password, then click Sign In to enter the portal. You will now enter the dashboard. The dashboard view is effectively the homepage of the SETS portal. From the dashboard, you can view all returns, both draft and submitted, see details of any outstanding balances, see an overview of any secure messages sent and received, and also view or amend any user account details. Ability to search returns by agent reference. From the dashboard, the general layout remains the same. Draft returns shown at the top, submitted returns and outstanding balances towards the bottom. In both sections, there is now a column showing your reference. If an agent reference has been added to individual or specific returns, this is where it would be displayed. Looking at these draft returns, no agent references have yet been included. To add an agent reference, select the draft return you want to amend. Click Continue, taking you into the return summary. At the moment, as no reference has yet been provided, to add one, click Edit Agent Details, and this gives you the option of amending any of the agent details. Entering content into the optional Your Reference field, clicking Next to review or amend any agent address details, and Next again takes you back to the return summary. From the return summary screen, you can see that your reference has now been added to this draft return. To save this reference in this draft return, click Save Draft and then return to the dashboard. Back in the dashboard, now that an agent reference has been added to the draft return, let me show you how you can use this information to search returns. From the dashboard, select All Returns to display a list of all returns in the system, draft and submitted. To search by agent reference, enter all or part of your reference into the Your Reference field and click Find. Returns with this reference information will then be displayed. Ability to delete draft returns. From the dashboard, the draft return section now displays an option to delete a draft return. Click delete, and once confirmed, that draft return has now been removed from the system. Please note, once deleted, individual draft returns cannot be reinstated. New return submission receipt. From the dashboard, the outstanding balance section towards the bottom of the screen shows submitted returns. A new receipt option gives the ability now to view, download, print, or save a new return submission receipt. Click Receipt to download a PDF version of the return submission receipt. This file can now be viewed, saved locally, or printed. This receipt option now makes the return submission receipt available at any time rather than just previously upon submission. New help text and links out to online help and guidance. New explanatory help text and hyperlinks out to online help and guidance have been added at various points throughout the portal. From the dashboard, select a draft return to work on. Click Continue, taking you into the return summary. All of the sections in the return summary are amendable, most now benefiting from additional help text and or hyperlinks out to online guidance. For instance, looking at the About the Transaction section, if we select the Edit Transaction Details, two new links out to legislative guidance on the Revenue Scotland website are now available. LBTT 4010 and LBTT 4012. Clicking Next to move forward, the About the Date section shows an example of both new explanatory help text, in this case on the effective date and relevant date. and also two new links out to online help. Firstly, to legislative guidance on the Revenue Scotland website, LBTT 1004, and then to information on the legislation.gov.uk website. Clicking next to the About the Transaction section shows a new link out to Revenue Scotland guidance. Save any changes made by clicking Save Draft. This returns you to the dashboard. Enhanced validation on reliefs. New and enhanced validation on reliefs have now been added to the portal. To demonstrate, let's continue a draft return. Click Continue, taking you into the return summary. Click Edit Transaction Details, clicking through until Reliefs on this transaction screen. This Reliefs on this transaction screen is where you would enter details of any reliefs being claimed for the transaction. If yes, select from the available list, noting that for most of the relief types, the system will now automatically calculate the amount of tax saved by the relief as part of the return, meaning a relief amount cannot be manually entered at this point. Other relief types, those listed as partial relief from the available list, can be manually entered in the amount of tax saved by the relief field. If you don't know the value, then enter zero. All reliefs amounts can be seen later in the return and can be changed as required before submission. Once complete, click Next to About Future Events, Next again to About the Conveyance or Transfer, and a final click Next to get back to the return summary. Save any changes made to this draft return by clicking Save Draft before returning to the dashboard.